And a man who opened fire on Baldwin County deputies and was eventually shot and killed yesterday was not a military veteran, as neighbors first told us.
Family members of Robert Yates say he suffered from mental illness and kept guns inside his home.
Deputies were at his home to serve an eviction notice that led to a shootout, a standoff, and eventually Yates' death.
Really, there were attempts to get cooperation going back well over a year. So you can boil down this incident to a certain period of time, but this situation began months and months ago and then got to this point, unfortunately.
NBC 15's Corey Pippen is digging deeper into what led to the fatal incident that put deputies' lives on the line.
We now know that Robert Yates was a loner who isolated himself inside his home, forcing deputies to kill him during what should have been a routine eviction.
This bullet-riddled, run-down trailer is all that remains one day after a tense 5-hour standoff between 65-year-old Robert Yates and Baldwin County law enforcement. But exactly what led up to the encounter that ended with Yates dead and numerous deputies shot at is still under investigation. Baldwin County Sheriff Huey Haas-Mack said last night that Yates never spoke to deputies and didn't show signs of the violence to come.
He did talk at one point in time to possibly 911 or a dispatch earlier on in the afternoon, but I do not know the total content of that conversation.
Neighbors tell NBC 15 Yates stayed to himself, but had threatened people in the past, accounts which Sheriff Mack is aware of, but can't confirm. Deputies arrived at his home in a trailer park off US 98 just outside of Fairhope around 1:30 yesterday afternoon with a court order to take him off the property. That's when investigators say he began shooting at them. According to investigators, Yates had been dodging eviction since 2016.
There were several complaints that the owner of the trailer park had, not mowing the grass, not keeping the shrubbery trimmed, just the overall upkeep of the outside of the trailer.
Yates wasn't a stranger to law enforcement in Baldwin County, with two arrests for stalking in 2013. Family members of Yates didn't want to speak on camera, but told NBC 15 Yates suffered from paranoia and had distanced himself from family for years. Despite everything, folks who interacted with Yates say they never thought it would come to this.
This is a very routine situation, and it turned deadly in the blink of an eye.
Yates' family confirmed to us that he owned three guns, but investigators have not released details on what kind of weapons were found at the scene. The investigation is still ongoing. In Baldwin County, I'm Corey Pippen, NBC 15 News.